things in check. Let's look at this story. Senior scientists have called for an end to all coronavirus restrictions, including mass testing and face masks, by the 21st of June. The 22 signatories to the open letter have criticised the government for confused and contradictory directions in pandemic management. The government remains concerned about variants that might evade immunity and a resurgence of the virus. Reference our last text. Let's speak to Professor Robert Dingwall, Professor of Sociology at Nottingham University, who signed this letter. Robert, good afternoon to you. Why did you sign along with your 21 other colleagues?
I signed because I read the small print on the Prime Minister's statement about how June the 21st was going to be a great day of liberation, and realised it wasn't, that all sorts of micromanagement of everyday life was envisaged to continue well into the autumn and indefinitely. And as you were just saying, the government was going to be very reluctant to give up its powers of surveillance and control that it had taken for the duration of an emergency. These things have a tendency to be very sticky.
Yeah, and as I was just alluding to, you know, we have to keep these people in check. This is that these are, you know, political masters, as it were, but they represent us. It's important that we know what they're up to. But I guess, you know, some would perhaps try to counter the sentiment of your letter, saying, well, hang on a second, you know, there is a big medical school of thought that face masks are not perfect, but, you know, they are better than nothing at all. So why don't we keep on with those for a little while longer? I can hear that argument coming around the corner.
Well, I think it's because, like the other signatories to the letter, I have great confidence in the real-world evidence of the success of the vaccination program. By the time we've gone another 2 or 3 weeks, all the highest risk groups in the country will have been fully vaccinated with their second dose. We need another 2 or 3 weeks beyond that for the immunity to develop as a result of that vaccination. Beyond that, you have to ask, what is the point of any further restrictions? The people who are at risk of serious illness and death are protected.
Correct.
By the vaccines. Those who are at medium and lower risk, I mean, we will be well into the process of giving them a first dose of the vaccine. You then sort of say, well, here is the first reasonable opportunity.
Yeah.
This is not a bunch of fringe people who are signing a letter saying, throw all the restrictions on a bonfire tomorrow. But it is saying, take the first realistic opportunity.
Yep.
And say never again.
And in fact, it wouldn't be pushing it too far, I don't think, Robert, to say this is what the government had told us, that the answer was the vaccine. And once people had got vaccinated, and once we addressed the vulnerable group, that, you know, just herd immunity just by catching it won't work, because people do have a habit of, you know, still involving themselves or hugging Nan or whatever. So the vaccine is the answer. I don't think it's stretching it to say that, you know, this is what Boris and Drs. Whitty and Valance and the like had been telling us.
Well, indeed, the chief medical officer has been saying since last autumn that we need to learn how to live with COVID, much as we live with influenza. And if we don't do stuff with flu, then the immediate question is, why would we do it for COVID once people have had the vaccine?
Where do you sense that, I mean, we often have these stories where a group of clinicians or scientists sign something. I'm always intrigued, what actually happens then? Does somebody deliver that letter somewhere? Does it get published in a newspaper? What do you hope happens now?
Well, we've published it in three newspapers and one political magazine. We've had a fair amount of coverage from other media. I think it's for others to take it up. As we've been clear all along, we're not a campaigning group. We're a group that really has very little in common other than our frustration with this constant language of doom and gloom that is coming from some of our colleagues.
Sure.
And the signatories of the letter, we're a very diverse group, but we have this common concern for the for the need to dismantle these restrictions at the first realistic opportunity.
Yeah. And I think most people would concur with that. Robert, thank you. Robert Dingwall, Professor of Sociology, Nottingham Trent University, who signed that letter.